Hello friends, myself Siddharth Chauhan, welcome to Easy MedChem. So today we are going to discuss about the tetracycline. Today's part of the video will be covering about the tetracycline. So in this section of the video about the tetracycline, first we will be covering about the First, we are going to cover about the introduction part. Some introduction part of the tetracycline. Next, after the introduction, we will discuss about the source and discovery about the tetracycline. Source and discovery. After the source and discovery, next we will be discuss about the chemistry point of view of tetracycline. Chemistry of tetracycline. After chemistry of tetracycline, we are going to classify the tetracycline. We are going to discuss about the classification of tetracycline. After classification, we are going to discuss about the mechanism of action of tetracycline. Mechanism of action of tetracycline. After this, we are going to discuss about the spectrum of tetracycline. After the spectrum, we are going to discuss about the some clinical uses of tetracycline. After this, we are going to discuss about the resistance mechanism of tetracycline. Resistance on tetracycline, and at last we are going to discuss about the some of the side effects of tetracycline. So in this section of the video we are going to discuss about this 9 points. First, we are going to discuss about the introduction. After the introduction, the source and discovery, then chemistry, then classification, then mechanism of action of tetracycline, then spectrum, then clinical use, then resistance mechanism, and at last we are going to discuss about the some of the side effects of the tetracycline. So let's start with the introductory parts of the tetracycline. So at first we are going to discuss about the introduction. So in under the introduction, first the tetracyclines are the broad spectrum drugs. They are the broad spectrum drugs. Second, they are bacteriostatic in nature. In contrast with the penicillin and cephalosporins, the penicillin and cephalosporins are bacteriocidal in nature, but these tetracyclines are bacteriostatic in nature. They target the bacterial protein synthesis mechanism or synthesis. They target bacterial protein . They reversibly bind to the 30S subunit of the ribosomes. Binds to 30S subunit of ribosome. Okay. They are the protein synthesis inhibitors. Protein synthesis inhibitors. And all the drugs which ends with the cyclines or which having a suffix cycline, they are under the tetracycline. So the suffix is cycline, such as a tetracycline, doxycycline, chlorotetracycline, oxytetracycline, demeclocycline, methacycline, doxycycline, minocycline. They all are tetracycline. After the introduction, next we are going to discuss about the source and discovery. Under source and discovery, now we are going to discuss about some source and discovery. Of tetracycline. Under this, we are going to discuss about, that is, the tetracyclines are discovered in something around 1940s, before the macrolides. Okay, so the first drug which was isolated is chlorotetracycline. The first drug which was isolated is chlorotetracycline, and it was isolated from Streptomyces aureofaciens by a scientist named Dugger. After the chlorotetracycline, then the oxytetracycline is isolated. After chlorotetracycline, the oxytetracycline is being isolated. Oxytetracycline is isolated, and it was isolated from Streptomyces rhinosis . Okay, so this is all about the source and discovery. After source and discovery, we are going to discuss about some chemistry of the tetracycline. Under the chemistry, it is a small subheading. Under the chemistry, we are going to notice about that it contains a tetracycline nucleus. It contains tetracycline nucleus, means a four ring nucleus, and the name it can also be named as polycyclic naphthysine nucleus. Okay, after the chemistry, we are going to discuss about some very important subheading, which is a classification. Classification of tetracycline. Under the classification, the tetracycline are divided into three categories. First one is a short acting tetracyclines. After the short acting, there are intermediate acting tetracycline. Intermediate acting tetracyclines are also present. After the intermediate acting tetracycline, the long acting tetracyclines are also present. Long acting tetracycline. So under the short acting tetracyclines, they have plasma T half life period of 6 to 12 hours. So the T half is 6 to 12 hours, whereas the T half of intermediate tetracyclines are 12 to 16 hours, and that of the long acting tetracycline, it is about 16 to 24 hours. Okay, about the dosing or the dosage, the short acting tetracyclines are given in 250 to 500 mg and it is OD once a day. Okay, and the dosage of intermediate tetracyclines are 300 to 600. They are BID, means twice a day. Okay, and that of the long acting tetracycline, they are given 100 mg once a day. And now some examples of tetracyclines under the short acting are tetracycline, oxytetracycline, chlorotetracyclines. They are the tetracycline, oxytetracycline, chlorotetracycline, and that of the intermediate tetracyclines are demeclocycline, and methacycline. And that of the long acting tetracycline is the example of doxycycline and minocycline. So this is all about the classification of the tetracycline. Now after the classification, we are going to discuss about the mechanism of action of the tetracyclines. So under the mechanism of action of tetracycline, now we are going to discuss about the mechanism of action. In short, MOA, mechanism of action of tetracycline. So under this subheading, we are going to discuss some of the points how the mechanism of action of tetracycline is being done. First, it enters into the bacterial cell by active transport. So entry into bacterial cell is by active transport. After this, it reversibly binds to 30S subunit. Reversible binding into 30S subunit. After that, it blocks binding of tRNA. tRNA to the acceptor site of mRNA ribosomal complex. And after that, it prevents addition of amino acid to growing peptide. So protein synthesis inhibited. This is all about the mechanism of action or MOA of tetracycline. Now after the MOA of tetracycline, we are going to discuss about the spectrum of tetracycline. We already know that under the spectrum, the tetracyclines are having a broad spectrum as compared to the macrolides. They are having a broad spectrum. For this, we have to know a mnemonic, that is GGRCTFVY. This is a mnemonic. For first G, that it is It can be used against the gram positive bacteria. The next G stands for the gram negative bacteria. Third one, it can be used against the rickettsia. Please check the spelling also. Rickettsia, under the rickettsia proboscis. And the rickettsia rickettsiae. The fourth one, see, it can be used against the chlamydia trachomatis. It can be used against the treponema, that is a spirochetes, treponema pallidum, can cause the syphilis. Sixth, it can be used against the yersinia. It can be used against the francisella. And at last, it can be used against the vibrio cholerae. That is very important. Vibrio cholerae. So these are the spectrum of the tetracycline, or it is having a broad spectrum, that is, it can be used against the gram positive, gram negative, rickettsia, rickettsia proboscis, rickettsia rickettsiae. Can be used against the chlamydia trachomatis. It can be used against the treponema, yersinia, francisella and vibrio. So after discussing about this spectrum, we are going to discuss some of the clinical uses of the tetracycline. So clinical uses of tetracycline. So under the clinical uses, it's not commonly used class of the drug because of resistant problem. This is very important. It is not commonly used class of the drug. Not commonly used class of drug because of resistance problem. And it can be mostly used for first. It can be used against the rickettsial infection. It can be used against the rickettsial infection, such as the lesions on the skin. Typhus fever, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, after rickettsial infection, it can be used against the mycoplasma infection. And under the mycoplasma infection, it can be used for mycoplasma pneumonia. After mycoplasma infection, it can be used against the chlamydial infection. Under the chlamydial infection, it can be used against the trachoma. The trachoma is infectious blindness. It is an infectious blindness. After the trachoma, it can be used against the venereal disease and in PID, pelvic inflammatory disease of women. Okay, so we are discussing about the clinical uses. After the chlamydia infection, it can be used against the spirochetes infection as well. It can be used against the spirochetes infection. Spirochetes infection. Under the spirochetes infection, we know about the Lyme's disease. So, under the Lyme's disease, it can cause the meningoencephalitis. It is very important point which I am discussing now. It can cause meningoencephalitis. Encephalitis, which is caused by Borrelia species. In this infection, arthropods such as the ticks are involved. It can cause death. In 24 hours. So the 100 mg of drug of tetracycline dose is required immediately. So this is all about some of the clinical uses of the tetracycline. After discussing about the clinical uses, we are going to discuss about the resistance mechanism by the bacteria under the tetracycline, the resistance. This is also very important topic. First, the resistance is by three mechanisms, 1, 2, and 3. They can be by three mechanisms. First one is the efflux pump mechanism. The tetracycline is being by active transport, they are being pumped outside or efflux outside. This is the first mechanism of resistance. After this, there is decrease in permeability of drug to the binding site. Decrease in permeability of drug to binding site. After this, the last one is the enzymatic degradation. Some enzymes are being produced which can degrade the tetracycline which enter the bacterial cell. Degradation. Okay, whatever is the spelling, you know that. After this, after the resistance, the last topic which we are going to discuss, that is very important one, we are going to discuss about some of the side effects related to tetracycline. Side effects. So, side effects. First one is the GIT disorders. Under the GIT disorders, the antibiotic associated diarrhea or the enterocolitis can occur. Antibiotic associated diarrhea. Or the enterocolitis can occur, and after that the inflammation of small intestine and colon can also occur. Inflammation of small intestine and colon can also occur. After this, the nephrotoxicity. Second one is nephrotoxicity related to kidney. under this nephrotoxicity, the first one is the Fanconi syndrome. What is Fanconi syndrome? The Fanconi syndrome, this syndrome is a kidney trouble disorder that causes the excess excretion of glucose, bicarbonate, uric acid, amino acid and the urine. So under the Fanconi syndrome, through the urine there is excess secretion of glucose. The glucose are excess secreted outside. The bicarbonates CO3-, uric acid, amino acids, so they are excreted outside in excess amount in Fanconi syndrome. After the Fanconi syndrome, they are contraindicated in children's. And should not be used with milk because it produces the complexation. Okay, so this is about the nephrotoxicity. After the nephrotoxicity, we are going to discuss another side effect of the tetracycline, that is the effect on growing bone and teeth. Okay, so causing retardation of the growing bone, they can cause a permanent staining of teeth due to the deposition of which substance? Due to deposition of calcium orthophosphate complex. Okay, and after that, this is effect on growing bone and teeth. They can also cause permanent photosensitivity if chronically used. If the tetracyclines are chronically used, they can lead to photosensitivity. After that, the demeclocycline, it can cause the diabetes insipidus. Because of its antagonistic effect on ADH. The demeclocycline is not being used as a antibacterial or antibiotic, but it is used against the diabetes insipidus, or it can also cause the diabetes insipidus. The use of the last effects or the side effect is the use of minocycline, which is also a tetracycline. The minocycline, or it is a long affecting tetracycline under the long affecting drug, it can cause ototoxicity. What is ototoxicity? Now we have to discuss about what is ototoxicity. It is a drug being toxic to ear and causes ear problem. This is ototoxicity. Can be used, it can cause the ototoxicity and causing, and it can also cause the ataxia. So this is all about the side effects of the tetracycline. I hope this is the end of the video. I hope you like the cover of mine. If do so, please like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for more informative videos. Thank you guys.